Hello, John Rutter here. Christmas is coming, 'tis the season to be jolly, and our thoughts turn to carols. For me, Christmas carols are like marker posts along the road in my life's journey. My first published composition, written when I was just 16, I think, was the Nativity Carol, and one of my most recent ones, Christ Our Emmanuel, also a carol, was written just this year. One of the lessons you learn in the playground when you're quite young is that not everybody in life is going to like you. And as a composer, you quickly learn that not everybody is going to like your work. If it's got any sort of personality, some people will take to what you write, others really will not. So I have learned to accept and bear with fortitude that my Christmas carols, which are a part of my life's work, are a Marmite experience. Some people enjoy them at Christmas time, others would just as soon not have to listen to them. I'd just say two things about that. One is that as an honest man, I do assure you that every one of them has been written sincerely and from the heart. And the other thing I would say is that if they have brought comfort and joy to at least some people at Christmas time, then that is the greatest reward any composer can hope for. Why transcribe them for piano? Well, the simple answer is that I got asked to. Over the years, people have said, well, I haven't got a choir in my living room. I'd quite like to be able to play your carols by myself. And like a number of projects, it was given a bit of a spur by the circumstances of this extraordinary year. And so I've chosen 8 of my carols and transcribed them for piano. How easy are they to play? Well, I've made them as simple as I can, but there comes a point if you peel too many layers of an onion away, then nothing remains. I hope that they're playable. There is one of my carols, rather a well-known one actually, which I knew I just would never be able to transcribe for any solo pianist other than Franz Liszt, and that's the Shepherd's Pipe Carol. If you've played the accompaniment, you'll know that it's quite a feat to get that nailed with just 10 fingers, and to have to play the voice parts as well, you need at least 20 fingers. So the Shepherd's Pipe Carol is not in the book. But there are 8 carols that are mostly thoughtful ones. The only jolly one is the Angel's Carol, which actually does lie under the hands quite nicely. The others are the gentler ones. And there's a rather special one that concludes the collection. It's called Mary's Lullaby. And why is it in there? Well, it's a long story, but I was a great friend of the wonderful jazz pianist George Shearing. And we became friends towards the end of his life. He was knighted in 2011. That was a great moment and very well deserved. And he always said he liked Mary's Lullaby. One evening when I was having dinner at his home in the Cotswolds, I think he played Mary's Lullaby to me and he said, John, you wrote that, didn't you? And I said, yes. And he didn't, of course, play it the way that I would have done. He played it George Shearing fashion. And if you know George's piano style, he liked very jazz-tinged harmonies. And so I thought as a tribute to a dear friend, I would conclude the album with an epilogue, which is Mary's Lullaby as George might have played it. I'm not exactly mimicking his style because it was inimitable, but let's say it's a homage. The kind of thing that you might perhaps play last thing at night before you close the covers of the album and the lid of the piano. So, enjoy the book, and it just remains for me to wish you a very happy and blessed Christmas.